What's going on, guys? JT Bethes here with another episode of LA Noir. And let's continue. Oh. Forgot to plug my controller in. There we go.
I did a little boxing in the Marines. I found it a pretty humbling experience.
Make you a sandwich, buddy. Corned beef and egg salad, 12 cents. Bologna and ham and cheese, 10.
It's strictly a mug's game. You'll like this fight, though. A plucky limey's about to take a beating from an up-and-coming Negro.
You sound pretty sure about the result.
I ought to be. I got 50 bucks on the black kid. Let's get a ringside seat. Son of a bitch Hammond made a run for his dressing room. Let's find out what's going on. God damn you, Albert! You get out here right now!
Step back! LAPD! What's going on?
That son of a bitch Hammond has jammed the door.
And who are you?
Carlo Arcaro. I'm his manager.
I'm his trainer.
Interesting attitude to have towards a victorious athlete.
Victorious? We had an arrangement.
We had a goddamn arrangement!
That limey bastard was paid to take a nap. He reneged.
And you were out of pocket?
Damn right. Me and a couple hundred other people.
Stand aside.
Let's check this place out.
He squeezed out the window. I'll put an APB out on him.
Why would we do that? He won the fight fair and square.
To prevent him from getting clipped. He was paid to flop. There was big money riding on this.
So are we here because you lost money? Or because we're investigating a prize fighting racket?
Very funny. Look around and see what you can find. Which is Hammond's locker?
Over by the pinboard, second from the end.
There's a phone number we can run by R&I. Plus a bunch of names and odds. You're not the only one who likes a flutter, Roy.
Nope.
This is
nope. Get out of my way.
You look troubled.
I'm in a jam, Doctor.
Can I help, Courtney? Is it money?
No, Doctor. That's okay. Do I have your professional confidence?
Whatever you say, we'll never leave this room.
I talked some of the guys in my old unit into doing something, and it's gone wrong. I guess I did it for the wrong reasons, for short-term gain. We came home from China on the Cool Bridge.
The morphine robbery.
That was us. I thought I could get the guys a fair share. Some sort of benefit for the sacrifices that they made in the war. Those guys deserve it, Doctor.
Oh, I'm sure they do, Courtney. But the deserving aren't always rewarded.
Tell me about it, Doc. We shifted our stuff onto this mob-connected guy, and it's been turning up all over town. It wasn't meant to be like this.
The presumption was rather naive, Courtney.
I know that now, Doctor. But people are dying.
Might I venture a few questions?
Sure.
Do your underworld contacts have all the morphine?
No, they don't. We doled it out, hoping we could control it.
Are they pressing you for further allocation?
That's the polite way of putting it, Doc.
I may be able to help you, Courtney.
Thanks, Doc. It helps just to talk about it.
I mean, I have a solution that will help you financially and salve your conscience.
I'm all ears, Doctor.
I will transact to take all the narcotic off your hands. You can rest assured that it will all be medically administered. I will use the funds that I no longer require for the purchase of medication and invest them in housing developments.
Housing?
The developments in question are housing projects for former servicemen. Your return will come from the sale of the properties. Your investment will benefit those that you care for most. Does this arrangement meet with your approval?
You're a magician, Doctor.
Let's see what else we got.
Cocksucker, and you bring him to me.
I feel bad too, Mickey. He guaranteed me he would take the flop.
I guarantee that you will be fish food if you don't bring me.
Roy, you out of pocket too?
Mickey, seems that way.
Don't worry about it. My boys are out looking for him.
Well, you'd better call them off. This is a police matter now. If anything happens to Hammond, I'll testify that you made threats against him.
Who's the Greyhound? He's a frisky one, isn't he?
Cole Phelps? Mickey Cohen.
I know who he is, Roy. I, met his brother-in-law.
I think you had the mixture pretty scared back there.
Yeah.
Operator, give me dispatch. Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address for the following phone number. AL345.
The address for the phone number is... The Hotel El Mar, 6294 Leland Way, Hollywood.
Thanks for your help.
You know the place? Flop House.
Let's go.
Quarter a night, no questions asked.
You know the way. You can drive.
Where are we going?
To the hotel, stupid.
You seem to have a pretty cozy relationship with Cohen and Stampinato.
Do I note a hint of reprimand in your tone, Detective? Talking to gangsters comes with the turf. You should try out Mickey's place. He's got a haberdasher's up on Sunset. See if he can get you out of those old man's clothes that you slink around in.
It's a front for his illegal activities.
It is that, but he does carry some very sharp suits.
If it's okay with you, I'll stick with Brooks Brothers.
Let's check this place out.
Yeah, what do you want?
I want some info, motherfucker.
We're making inquiries into the whereabouts of an Albert Hammond.
No one here by that name.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure. This isn't the sort of place where people use their real names. Take a look at the register if you don't believe me.
Isn't he the cop that won the medal and is solving all the cases?
Yes, that's me.
Okay, so look for prominent Tommies. That should narrow it down.
Is someone gonna tell us what the hell is going on?
Winston Churchill, a very patriotic Englishman, is staying in room 207.
The old bulldog. Even at a flop house, Adley can't get out from his shadow.
What I miss?
The early bird gets the worm.
He must be heading home. You know, I hope he makes it.
That crooked son of a bitch? No chance. Looks like he's had a broad up here.
Yes, yes it does.
Hey, fuck you!
I guess a fighter has plenty of time on his hands between bouts. Does Albert have somebody special? I didn't see anyone in his corner at the fight.
It's because she's a bitch.
Still warm.
InstaHeat. Adrian Black's product of choice. Seems like a lifetime ago.
Candy has expensive taste. Albert has his work cut out for him.
Who's Candy?
Candy Edwards, the lady who filled out this coupon. Looks like Albert has been doing some homework. 11 grand would be a nice little nest egg.
All right, let's go after his girl. See if that gets us any closer.
Is this angle if he has a real love interest?
All right, let's go.
You got a problem, pal?
What? What'd you say to me, boy? Yeah, that's what I thought. Better back up, fool. I'm a cop. Actually, I'm a detective, but still. What are you doing getting on my side? Get your ass over.
Can you drive to this one?
Fine, where are we headed?
So, you boxed in the Marines?
We all did. Standard training.
I can't imagine you ever played dirty.
The only prize for taking a fall was 1,000 push-ups.
Thank you.
We need to know which room is Candy's.
Not if they're Sherlock.
Can I help you, John?
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Candy Edwards.
Apartment 7. You take the outside stairs by the parking lot and turn left at the top.
Thank you, sexy.
You friends of the Italian guy.
Italian guy?
Yeah. Sleazy type. Gave his name as Carlo. I didn't like the look of him, but Candy has some funny friends.
Thanks.
This Candy broad must be as sweet as she sounds. All these gentlemen callers.
I know, right?
Give it up,
sounds
bitch.
Like we're missing all the fun. Get in there.
Like hitting women, do you?
This isn't gonna end well for you, friend.
Get down, bitch.
Out cold, but breathing. Give her a minute and take a look around.
Sure, fancy stuff right there, Fielder. Mm-hmm.
Optimistic, Cole. Doesn't give me anything to go on.
Single ticket, one way. I guess there isn't a lot for Albert in Ohio. Huh? Scania sails from New York. Nasty weapon. All the Italians carry them. A real man uses his fists or a gun.
Don't worry, guys. He's not dead. Just unconscious.
Carlo here seems to have the same friends as Hammond. What are the odds on them all being bookmakers? Take a seat, Miss Edwards. We have some questions for you to answer.
Look, I haven't done anything wrong.
Ever? I find that pretty hard to believe.
Ooh.
Can you answer some questions now, Miss Edwards?
Sure, I've had worse. I'll shake it off.
We're trying to track down Albert Hammond.
I'm gonna do so bad at this.
Do you know where he is?
No, I don't. I'm over Albert. I haven't seen him.
You're lying, Candy. You were in his hotel room. He came back after the fight and you weren't there. What happened?
You can't prove that I was in the room.
Want a bet?
How do you think we found you, Candy? You wrote your name and address on a coupon.
Look, Albert was supposed to take a fall. We were all supposed to make a little money out of it. But Albert got too goddamn stubborn. Said his pride was all he had left. So I told him, shove it. Let's see his pride keep him warm at night.
So you walked out before the fight?
Yes, I did. What's the problem? I didn't take anything.
Do the names Harry, Mervin, or Ray mean anything to you?
Could be anybody. How the hell would I know?
Give up these men, Miss Edwards. God
damn it, she's lying.
Letting these charges against you slide.
What? Charges against me? All I did was try and look out for Albert. Now he skips out and I have to take beatings for him as well?
You're leaving town, Miss Edwards?
Yes, I'm going straight home.
You're lying to me. Albert finally won a big fight. I say good luck to him. But you know where he is. Let me help him, Candy.
Do all you cops run off at the mouth? Prove I know where he is. I don't know where he is, and if I did, I wouldn't tell you.
Well, get out of your way, Candy.
Always do bad at this one. Always.
Like I said, I've done nothing wrong.
The LAPD expects a little more cooperation. You'd better watch your back, sister. Get out, Carlo, you hump. And get rid of that pig sticker. You ever pull that thing on me, I'll shoot you like a dog. That bitch knows where Hammond is. She knows where my money's gone. My money too, tough guy. I'll handle this. Bad people are looking to hurt Candy, and yet she's not heading straight for the train station? I smell a payoff. I say stake her out. See where she goes.
That's what I'm saying, Broseph.
Tail is broad. Don't let her get away, but don't get spotted. I'll bring up the car behind you.
Sure you will. Alright guys, well that's going to do for today's episode of LA Noir. If you like what you're seeing, make sure you hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button. If you want to know anytime I go live or post a video, make sure you hit the bell symbol next to my name. I'll notify you anytime I go live with the live stream or again post a video. As well as going to my Facebook page and the Outcast Posse's Facebook page and my Twitter, which the links to those are in the description below. As well as everybody's YouTube channel and everybody's Twitch channel. So make sure you check them out because they're always posting some badass shit. But until next time, guys, I'll talk to y'all later.